Hello there. In this video, I want to go over one of the most important topics if you're interested in learning how to do backgrounds, and that is doing landscape studies. In case you're not familiar, a study is what you call when you grab a picture you like about any topic and make a quick rough copy with the goal of learning something. Making studies is widely considered to be the best way to learn to make backgrounds, whether they are photorealistic or cartoons. Everyone benefits of doing studies. Now, this is a channel on Inkscape and cartoons, so the idea of this video is to show you how you can go around making studies in Inkscape using only the keyboard and mouse, and of course with the goal of applying what you learn to cartoon backgrounds. I will separate this video in two parts. In this part, I will demonstrate everything you need to make a study in Inkscape, and in the next video, I will go over how to turn studies into unique backgrounds different from the references. And the first step is to pick the right references. One of the first things you notice as you start doing studies is how easily you can turn them into full backgrounds with just a bit of work, and that's great. But if your background looks too similar to the original photo, you may or may not end up with some problems if you use it in a commercial project without license. Pictures taken from Google Photos or Pinterest are usually copyrighted. That's not a problem if your goal is to learn on your own, but if you decide to use the results in a commercial project, I would recommend you to go for a site like Pexels, which contains images that are free to get and free for commercial use. In the case of this tutorial, we will be using a common image from Pinterest because we have more options and it's not going to be used in a commercial project. So what type of images should you pick? Anything that you like is fine, but prioritize images that have beautiful, unique, or just interesting color schemes and clearly defined shapes. Making studies involves simplifying complex forms into simple shapes, and it's easier if the reference already has simple, well-delineated shapes. Also, for now, stay to landscapes and avoid things that may require a specific study, like a composition that includes, say, a statue, which will require extra study of the figure, or maybe a particularly complex ship or building. Anything that includes a subject which may require its own study to make it look right. So for now, stay to generic landscape and cityscapes compositions. At the end of the day, you're going to have to simplify and adapt the complex shapes you see in the picture to more simple and flat shapes. So it's going to be helpful to have a couple of extra references of actual cartoon backgrounds with similar subjects to what you're copying, just to see how the pros are simplifying some of that complexity. If you're studying a beach, bring in a cartoon illustration of beaches to see how the artists are simplifying the sand and the sea. If you're studying a forest, bring in illustrations of forest to see how they make the plants and the masses of foliage, etc. Okay, here I got the main reference that I will be copying, in this case a very simple and easy beach and a lighthouse composition. Something like this is what you want when you're starting out because it's simple and you can do the study in like 15 minutes. And then here to the side, I got some cartoon references to help me make the rocks and water. But before we begin, let's clarify what our goals are. We don't want to make something finished here. Our goal is to just train our eyes to understand the colors, values, composition, and shapes that mix up a scene like this in the reference. As a result, we don't want to make something that looks good. Always prioritize speed. This way you can do more studies and learn more in less time. Don't spend more than 20 minutes in a copy. And remember that if you have any problem with anything of what I'm doing here, make sure to watch the Inkscape mini course here on YouTube, where you'll learn everything you need to take any of my other tutorials. Link in the description. Also, don't forget to like and comment, it helps me a lot and helps the channel to grow. And of course, subscribe for weekly tutorials on Inkscape and illustration. Let's begin then. When I'm studying a background, I always like to start defining the area of where the composition is going to go. So I'm going to use a rectangle to match the area in the reference, and then move it to the side. This shape is also going to double as the farthest away thing in the composition, which is going to be the sky. So we can just sample the sky color by dragging with the dropper. This will show a circle, which shows how much of the color is taken into account. You're gonna have to do this with all colors that you sample from any picture. JPEGs and other formats are usually very grainy, so if you just click to sample, you run the risk of sampling a color that's not representative of the overall color of the area. Anyway, continuing. The next big shape should be the water. Again, I'm going to use a rectangle and sample the color of the water. Now that I got the sky and water, the next big shapes are the rocks. And here it is another important part of making studies, simplification. If you pay attention and zoom right in, you'll realize that all of these shapes are made of a ton of tiny and not so tiny rocks, all lumped together into a single big mass. One important skill to learn when you're making studies is to identify what information can be left out and what to keep in. I don't need to draw these tiny rocks and planes or be that accurate with the silhouette for it to read as what it is, a piece of dark land. So I'll simplify it into a single mass. Well, two single masses and a few other smaller ones for these rocks in the center. Notice that the silhouette of the shape does not match with the real one. It's roughly in the same shape, but not exact. The goal here is not to be accurate with the shapes, but rather that they read nice and easily. Pictures don't always have the most clear and defined shapes, so that means that most of the time you'll want to take some liberties with the shapes and simplify them even further. You'll notice that I will be doing this all throughout the rest of the study. Clarity and simplicity always takes precedence. And it's not just the shapes you should take liberties with. If something offers more clarity, you should go for it. In this case, illumination. I look at the cartoon references and notice that the rocks have very clearly defined light, something that in the main photo does not happen. So I decided it would look nice if I do that. I completely improvised some quick light, and in my opinion, it really ended up looking better, giving it more depth and more clarity, which is always the main goal. I'm also not gonna sweat too much the shape of the lighthouse. In fact, I picked this image because the lighthouse was so simple that I could just throw together some simple shapes and it wouldn't affect the overall composition. It would have been different had the lighthouse been something more complex or unique that would require some special attention. But here I'm also using the cartoon reference to change completely what's on the image and make something much faster, just like with the rocks. And just like with the rocks, here I thought a bit of illumination would help the overall composition, so that's what I'm doing. To me, this makes much more sense as a vector illustration, and it looks great. I'm also taking some liberties with the details. They are not exactly following what the picture shows, but I think this works better as a cartoony vector illustration. If it's not clear by now, the objective of this study is not to make a perfect duplicate of the original, but to build your own quick illustration from the ground up, basing it on the picture. And the one thing I feel will make this illustration much better is to add some of that sea foam that shows up in the cartoon references that I gathered. I know it's not on the original, but I feel like it needs it, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm also making this foam shape all around the rocks. I want you to notice that as I'm making this foam shape all around the rocks, I'm actually going super fast. This goes back to what I said earlier that this isn't meant to be a finished illustration. It can be if you want later on to keep refining it, but as it is now, this is just a super quick illustration that I'm making with the goal of learning, so I'm not taking too much time with anything. Another thing I couldn't resist was to add some clouds in the background, just like the ones in the cartoon references. And one final thing I decided to add, this wasn't in any particular reference, but I just thought it would look good, some type of green here, so I added a couple of bushes here and there. Okay, it's done. And honestly, I like my version much more than the one in the picture already. And it only took me about 20 minutes to do. A couple of things to notice here. First, even if the illustration is super rough, even if I don't even bother to smooth out some of the corners and add any type of detail, because all of these shapes match and are well defined, they read like what they are supposed to be. They still look good at a glance, and that's exactly what we want. And second, Doesn't this look a bit like a thumbnail? Thumbnails are rough and quick mini illustrations that you do to plan out a preview of how a final illustration gonna look. Making a thumbnail is the first step to making a finished illustration. So what I'm saying is that making a study can be a great first step to make a full illustration. And that's what the next video is gonna be all about. How to combine multiple studies to make completely unique compositions and use them as thumbnails for a finished illustration. But that's for the next video. For now, I would highly appreciate it if you give me a thumbs up and tell me what you thought in the comments. Also consider subscribing to the channel for more illustration and Inkscape videos. See you on the next one. Bye.